Welcome to today's numeracy tutorial. Our learning objective today is to multiply more than two numbers. As always, we'll get ready for our lesson with a five-question brain gym. Get ready to warm up. Here are the five questions for you to have a go. But before you pause the video, I'd like to highlight something from question one. It instructs you to complete the factors of 15, but you might not know what the word factor means. The factors of a number are the numbers that divide equally into that number. You can see that 1 and 3 are factors of 15 already, because both of these numbers divide into 15 without leaving remainders. I'll not hold you back any longer. Off you go and complete the questions. Okay, did you work out that the two other factors of 15 are 5 and 15? I can divide 15 into 3 equal groups of 5. And I can divide 15 into one group of 15. Question 2 and 3 rely upon us knowing our times table facts. At this stage, you should be working really hard to know all of your times table facts off by heart so that you can recall the facts rapidly. Quick fire. Question 2, 21. Question 3, 9. Question 4 is checking that we can recall that there are 1,000 metres in 1 kilometre. If you know that, well then, there are 9,000 metres in 9 kilometres. Question 5 is our time question. The clock's minute hand is pointing to 5, showing that there are only 5 minutes until the next hour. This means it is 5 minutes to, we can see the next hour is 5, it is 5 minutes to 5. And we write that as a digital time, 4:55. Remember, digital time is always left to right, the hour and the minutes past the hour. Now we are ready to focus on our learning objective for today. Multiplying by more than two numbers. Let's give it a go. Greg is back with a question. He wants to know how many stickers are there in total on the teacher's desk. We can see the stickers are set out in 3 arrays. We can calculate how many stickers there are in each array and then multiply by 3. Good thinking. The first array has a column of 5 stickers multiplied by 2, which is equal to 10 stickers. There are 10 stickers on one sheet. Now that we know how many stickers there are on one sheet, we can multiply that by 3 to find out the total number of stickers. There are 5 groups of 2 on each of the sheets. There are 3 groups of 5 multiplied by 2, and we can write that as 5 times 2 times 3 is equal to 5 times 6. Pause the video a minute just to check that you understand how that number sentence relates to the picture that Greg's shown us. What multiplications are shown by these arrays? Pause the video and have a think. The first array has 3 blue cubes multiplied by 2, which is equal to 6 blue cubes. The second array has 6 cubes multiplied by 4, which is equal to 24 cubes. Have a look at these arrays and the sentences. Can you fill in the missing numbers? There are 4 groups of 6. So there are 4 groups of 3 multiplied by 2. Look at the link between this group and our earlier array. In just the same way, I want you to work through this next challenge with me. In this array, we have 4 counters and they're multiplied by 2, which is equal to 8 counters. What multiplication is shown by this array? Have a think. There are 8 counters multiplied by 6, which is equal to 48 counters. Have a look at this next group of counters. Can you see how our red counters could, in fact, match the yellow array? Pause the video now and try to complete the sentences and fill in the missing numbers. There are 6 groups of 8 counters. So we can actually say there are 6 groups of 4 multiplied by 2. Look at how the two sets of counters match. So we can actually say 6 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 2 is equal to 8 multiplied by 6. How many ways can you use all 3-digit cards to fill in the multiplication sentence? Right, pause the video now and have a wee think. I'm going to start with the 2 in the starting place. So I can write 2 times 5 times 3, 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 5. If we use 3 in the starting place, I could write 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 5, or 3 multiplied by 5 multiply by 2. And my last option would be placing 5 at the starting position. There are 6 ways of completing the multiplication sentence. Does the order in which we complete the calculations affect the total product? Let's see. We can multiply the numbers in any orders, and the product is always going to be the same. This is because multiplication is commutative, and that means we can decide which order to multiply depending on which we find easier. Leonardo has painted some number sentences for us, but he's not too sure whether they are correct. Can you work out if Leonardo is correct without calculating? Pause the video now and have a wee think. Remember, try not to do all of the calculations. Let's have a look together. In the first number sentence, we can see that 4 multiplied by 2 is equal to 8, which gives us 8 multiplied by 5. 8 and 5 are greater than 4 and 7, so the product of 8 and 5 will be greater than the product of 4 and 7. Alternatively, we could have found that 2 multiplied by 5 is equal to 10. So this gives us 4 multiplied by 10, and 4 multiplied by 10 is greater than 4 multiplied by 7. His first equation is not correct. Maybe he'll have better luck with the second one. In the second equation, we again have 5 multiplied by 2, which is equal to 10. This gives us 4 multiplied by 10 is greater than 4 multiplied by 9. That's correct. Well done, Leonardo. Here we have another comparison number sentence. It shows that 8 multiplied by 6 is greater than 2 multiplied by a missing number multiplied by 4. What missing numbers could go in the missing box? Pause the video and have a think. Well, how do you think you got on? We can multiply the 2 and 4 together because we can multiply the 3 numbers in any order, thanks to multiplication being commutative. So, now that we have multiplied 2 and 4, we've got 8. 8 multiplied by 6 is greater than 8 multiplied by our missing number. So 6 has got to be greater than our missing number. This means our missing number could be or 0. That's our tutorial finished for today. Having worked through all of those challenges, you are now ready to complete your independent task. You're more than ready. As per normal, good luck!